So the gyms are closed. What do I do to stay in shape this whole time? That sounds interesting. Let's hop into it. So this is my training area. I do here all kinds of things. You can just imagine. Use your imagination what I do with it. All this equipment. This is a bar for overhead press or military press. Biceps, back, deadlift, everything I do with it. I even stocked on a vest. With a vest, I put in it some weights. It's weigh 20 kilos, this vest. Let me try. Lift it up. I have this chain that I put some weights on it and then lift myself with more weight. I have a belt. I have some things to strap on my legs to make it harder. I have those cables to do all kinds of stretches, biceps, shoulders, triceps, chest. I have some punching gloves that I don't really use anymore. I use them to punch this bank, but I don't use it anymore. There are so many weights here that I stacked up on, that I, if I put them all together in here, it's about 120 or 130 kilograms. I can do deadlifts with it. And most importantly, have this beautiful pull-ups bar. Oh yes, I use this thing every day. It's amazing. That was the best investment. So I mostly use this bar for pull-ups, obvious, right? It's amazing investment. Of course, I use it for chin-ups. Oh yes, this was the best investment. And yes, in case you're wondering, it is Edge Lifestyle, so you know what to do, right? Yeah? You don't want to see me in flip-flops in the house with this look, do you? Or this? Or this? Haha, that's why I put shoes for this special occasion. So this is the chain I was talking about. You strap a weight in your waist. You jump and stop performing. It's so good. Toss a coin to your witcher, a valley of plenty, valley of plenty. Ah. Let's start with various exercises I can do with those cables. First is of course biceps. There are 5 levels of intensity you can adjust as you wish. You can do biceps, you can do dead roll raises, you can do front shoulders with it, and you can do triceps with it, even though it's tricky a little bit. You go like this and bend down. So this provides a great stretch. This is amazing, but I don't use it much because I have other alternatives for this. Next we have 5 gallons of water. This thing is heavy. I primarily use it for bent over rows because it's extremely heavy. I get it from my water carrier that brings it to my door. A couple of weeks, so it's excellent weight. You can get it from wherever you get it and do various exercise with it at home. It's amazing. Never thought I would make a use for it. And I'll use it just like this. It's amazing for your back. The rows are good. It's very heavy, but you can still use it. I have other things that replace it. Next, let's talk about chest. So just because I have this bar and those weights, I don't actually have a chair or a bench. I only have those 2 chairs. A lack of bench is sad, but I have some alternatives. I have this when I do push-ups and some dips where they can go deeper. Those beautiful cables that I use them. I have those amazing cables for some stretch. They are rated as high intensity on the scale. They are easy, moderate, and high. These are the highest available resistance. It's amazing. Doing between 10 and 12 reps with this is really makes a good stretch in the chest.
Next, I have those beautiful things that I prefer over regular push-ups, because it allows me to go even deeper than regular push-ups. Really get down there, because switching to this is good. And go again with a little bit more emphasis on the real deltoid. Probably saying that was the upper chest and the middle. What about the lower chest exercise? For that I don't really have anything except those cables that can bring behind me and put it forward like this for the lower chest. It's good. It's not like the Smith machines in the gym. It gets the job done. I'm gonna grab some weights and just do this if you wish. The lower chest.
Next we have the squats. I do squats with this bar. It's very heavy if I try to lift it by myself, so I can't really go with high weight here, especially since I live alone. If shit happens, nobody gonna come and rescue me. So I have to go really lightweight with this thing when I'm doing squats.
And of course, to start this whole show is the bar. You can do many things with it. For example, you can do squats with it. You can do overhead press. You can do behind the neck press. Even though I never do. You can bend and do the back. You can do back rows and change your grip.
Oh yes,
like
yes.
This.
Oh yes.
Change your grip like this.
Oh, yes.
And do it like this. You can do deadlifts for it with enough weight. You can do stiff deadlifts for it. Anything you want, especially bicep curls. For triceps, there are many variants. This is one of them. So you bring it behind your back. There is this one behind your head. This is one of them. This is one of them. I'll just grab it. And pretend this is the cable, so it will exactly work in the gym. It's very good. After 20 reps, you can really feel it in your muscles. This is one of them. And this is another one. I like it for the triceps, my favorite. So you're probably thinking, just because of this case
of recent events,
I went and bought it and stocked up before the gym closed. No, I assembled this collection like a year and a half
ago.
I went to my local sports shop and I bought all the weights, the bar, the sand weights for the legs, for the arms. Everything else I ordered online, such as the belt, the vest, the cables, the chains. They didn't have it, including some liquid chalk. And many of my friends and other people, I told them about this small gym area I have at home. It was like some time. It's not like I bragged everywhere and to everyone about this. No, I spoke about this to my friends. I told them about it. I spoke to some people at the gym, some people at groceries, etc., etc., wherever I could to tell them about this. And many told me, but you have a gym membership. Why the hell do you bother making a small gym in your house? You're going to the gym every day anyway. Why the hell would you have it at your house? And I told him, look, for those days like Saturdays when the gym are closed, or for holidays when the gym are closed, I still want to be able to do a good workout at home. But you still have a membership, so Why would you bother? You have all the Smith machines in there. You have everything you would ever need, even more than this. Why do you bother? Some people called me stupid because, yeah, it costs a lot of money. And, you know, the jokes on them, but now why? Because those friends and some of the people are still in connection with them and told them about this. All of them cried to me in the comments, in the messages. Oh, you were the only smart one. We are the stupid now. You were the only smart one that you still able to exercise. If you really want to go back to the gym, if you really want to go and train, but you can't do it. I offered them to come to my place and do a workout at my place, but I said, no, thank you. We are afraid to get out of the house. I understand. This situation is difficult. I didn't know such a situation would come. Nobody really knew about it, but I'm really happy I have all this equipment. So every day I wake, I do a little bit of workout. Not as intensive as in the gym like I used to be. And when the gym opens, I will run straight to the gym. Just this is a very good equipment to give me a good challenge. My favorite are the overhead press with some pull-ups and chin-ups and some chest. The moral of the story is do things you like. Do the things that you think are okay. Don't always think to opinion of other people. Like they told me, you're stupid, you're stuck up on this gym equipment. You still have your gym membership, so why don't you use it? Why do you build a small gym at home? I didn't listen to anyone. I built it because I wanted, because I thought it was a good idea. Seems like it was a good idea after all. So even though I'm not leaving the house or going anywhere, I'm still trying to keep my daily routine and grooming on point. Try to keep my game strong. Even though I'm not going anywhere, I do it for myself.
Oh yes. Oh yes, so I'm still keeping my grooming habits on point, on check, in my daily routine, working on my hair, working to powder my balls, yes. And of course my face, the most important feature of the body, right? Even though I'm not leaving the house and nobody sees me, it doesn't matter. I still keep my grooming and manscaped on point.